so awesome.
Front row. I have no idea.
Backstage pass.
It's got Bruce's name on it.
Open it.
Open it up.
What'd he say?
Probably.
Stuff together because I'm going to do a little jamming for you, but it's kind of real structured. I'm actually going to jam to a couple of tracks from Revenge. So just give me a minute to sound check, and then I'll get a chance to meet all you guys and give you autographs and sign whatever you got or take a photo, okay? So hang on a second.
Fuck, we forgot something. Give it to him so he can see.
Can we hold it or you got it?
I can.
Sweet.
All right.
Sorry, we got it coming my way. I got to get a tape. What are you doing? Here, get this. Just get this real quick. Could you?
Okay, thanks.
Oh my God! It
looked at me like
and share.
Hello, Mr. Video.
Over here, down here, Tim.
So, I don't know, something about Marshall amps and Kiss is pretty synonymous, you know. Nothing better than playing a loud guitar through a loud stack and all that. And it's not a situation that's, my relationship with Marshall has been a long time, when I was pretty young actually. I remember my first job working at some library in New York, I was saving up money to buy a 100-watt Marshall amp so I could blow up the neighborhood. And sure enough, it worked, I'll tell you. So, they have a lot of different models. I think all the stuff is good. The head I happen to use is the 900 series, the 2100 head. It's kind of one of those heads that you don't have to deal with the, you know, modifying it. It's got enough crunch. The Spinal Tap aesthetic can go to past 10. This one goes to 20, you know, instead of 11. But I get plenty of good sounds out of that. And I still use, you know, don't be afraid of using pedals with your amps, because I got a lot of little...
A little
distortion pedal here, and I got an analog delay pedal. And for you women that don't play guitar or anything, just ignore what I'm saying with the equipment. But I got a wah-wah pedal happening here. But all that kind of stuff helps in the studio, and I think you should don't worry about so much what I play. Go for what you want to do. But you know, this is how I prefer my guitar to sound. And just to something about the Marshall sound, and that I'm real happy with the kind of crunch, that warm, too, you know, loud stuff that really, really makes your neighbors, you know, hate you, okay? All right, so what I'm going to play, instead of just, like, jamming with some strangers, or instead of just talking to you, I'm going to jam a couple of the tunes from Revenge. The first song is called Thou Shalt Not, which Gene sings, but this is a rough mix, actually, so, like, he sings some of it, and he doesn't sing some of it, which, so if you're familiar with the new album Revenge, it's going to sound a little strange, but it gives me a chance to play in the spots that he's not, and sometimes I'll just play rhythm, and other times I'll be just playing leads. So, again, it's just a rough thing, and obviously there are no leads on the tape, so I'll be doing all that stuff here. So, and we'll stop and talk for a minute after that, okay? So, you'll stop it after that one, like, after five, okay? Okay, all right, you keep an eye on me if it's loud or whatever, whatever. Okay, all right, here we go. I want to hear the very beginning, okay? I told you that machine is very tricky, okay? Did that sound right to you? We'll be right back. He wants a photo opportunity to be sweating. Anyway. As you can tell, it had some voice and some not voice. Next song, unfortunately, has no voice, okay, but it's a Paul Stanley song.
Yeah.
It's called Heart of Chrome. It's a real cool track on the album. For me, the best thing about the track on this one's real laid back kind of feel. And that's not always easy to accomplish, so I'll try to lay back. You know,
he's
studio,
not
going to
play Dom.
Concentrate.
Okay.
Excuse me, live, the band goes crazy.
Play an old,
we do whatever we want. You know, if it gets fast, it gets fast. It's okay. We feed off
the
noise.
Play the beginning.
Here I have to kind of play studio strict with the track that's happening. So, same thing though, but there's no vocals happening on this one, okay? I'm going to try to do a lot of those riffs from the record. Okay, here we go. Number 6 on the DAT tape, Heart of Chrome.
DAT tape.
Yeah.
Texas, huh? Yeah, sure. I'll take some questions in a second. I'll tell you, sometimes something like this is, you know, if you play in front of 10,000 people, it's like, yeah, all right. But you play for, you know, people as intimate as this, and it's pretty crazy. So, okay, that was fun. I had more fun on the second one. I got comfortable there. Okay, so I'll take some questions about KISS, about nothing personal, politics, please, but, you know, about the amps or whatever. Okay, yeah.
Is the crunch built in, or is that an effects pedal?
No, I mean, what I try to do is, I try to set these, I didn't even look at it. However, the headset sounded pretty good to me. I didn't even get into it. I know you can get more crunch out of it, but I was using like a little distortion plus for some overdrive. Some of the Revenge record was recorded that way with a distortion pedal in front of the amp. Most of it wasn't, but some of it was for the craziest stuff, you know. You see, that leaves me to the pleasure of having it set for good rhythm sounds, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, you can also use the AB channels on the amp, you know.
What's
that? You know, this will have an A channel that's a little cleaner than the B, but I like to kind of keep it simple, you know. And look, Kulick used Marshalls, and they play it through fuzz faces, and you know, people like that have done it. A lot of the bands out there now that are making a lot of noise, they step on some crunch pedals, so don't be shy, you know, about it.
Okay.
You can use a fuzz box, it sounds good, yeah.
Do you know when you're playing Erie?
Erie, Pennsylvania?
Yeah.
All right.
I don't know, you know. I know we played Hershey and Allentown. I'm not sure. I don't know if that's on there. Oh, this guy. You speak to this man after the show. And he'll,
How much writing do you get involved with KISS in the studio, and which one is it harder to work with, Dean or Paul?
Oh, good question. They're actually both really, really different styles, you know. Gene likes like kind of like heavy riffs and kind of darker stuff, Paul is more varied in the sense that he could be really melodic, and yet, you know, I think it's better when he stays tougher, but, you know, he's written a lot of the more popular stuff we've done, too. They're both, everyone's creative, but, you know, both in their own eccentric ways, you know. It's tough to say which one's tougher. It's just, Gene's got a million ideas, but some, you know, sometimes it's hard to tell him, like, no, I don't like that, you know, and you keep going with his enthusiasm, and Paul's really thoughtful, always like, I don't know if that's right yet. We should work on it some more, you know. So, but we get together and we really nail the stuff as you know, we work on it as hard as we can. I mean, I think that's one thing we really did on Revenge. We didn't compromise, and we were brutal on each other. Hey, I don't like that. We don't like this. And we had Bob Ezra in there to like help out, you know. So that was fun about that record. Yeah.
Which are all favorite KISS songs?
Oh, that's a big question there. Boy. Well, that's always fun because it brings down the crowd go crazy. Detroit Rock City is really cool.
Hell yeah.
You know, it's like an anthem for the band.
Yep.
And other stuff that I've recorded with the band, I think Tears Are Falling is cool.
Yeah.
I love the song. And anything from Revenge I really dig, actually. Yeah,
what's your personal opinion on Ace Frehley's playing? And when you do the old stuff live,
right.
Guys kind of say, dude, the Ace
thing. Yeah. Well, actually, I have a lot of respect for Ace. I mean, when I first joined the band in 84, it was like, you know, then like a whole other style of rock music seemed to be popular, and everyone was doing finger tapping and Eddie Van Halen things. And the band, you know, I could do some of that stuff, so I incorporated some of that into the KISS style. But classic KISS is more kind of straight ahead, you know, Jimmy Page kind of riffs. That's where Ace was from. So when we do a lot of the old stuff, if you're going to be at the concert tonight, you know, I think what Ace did, especially on Live 1 and 2, is really special. So I basically play pretty close. I do me, but, you know, I use a lot of those kind of riffs. Some of the solos are almost exact. Some are very similar. And I have a lot of respect for that kind of stuff. But something's a classic, don't hurt it. You know, don't screw it up by trying to be into it. And since we do it, I feel like I do a good job. Some people say, oh, you do those ace-isms very well. So that's cool. Well, I really loved, of course, when Jimi Hendrix came out. I thought that was amazing. And Jimmy Page, Led Zeppelin, and then Jeff Beck, and Eric Clapton, Cream, especially those days. That was like really, I was going crazy with that when I was young. I couldn't figure out, though, if I should be Jack Bruce or Eric Clapton. So I used to play bass also. But, and other recent players, of course, you know, Eddie Van Halen I've loved, and I think Satriani's great, people like that, you know. Yeah, yeah.
Not to bring up bad things, it's hurtful time in the band, but when Eric passed, it was mentioned that he was writing music with you for cartoons. Were you hearing any of that?
I sure hope so. Actually, oddly enough, the Eric was involved with, he was always into animation, you know, and he had this idea about animated rock band, and, you know, be some musicians like myself and other people that he knew in the business that he'd write stuff for, and we did write some songs for it so he could present it to people, and a few people wanted to buy it, actually, so obviously now that he's passed on, and oddly enough, in some way it's still related to myself and the band, and I think he kind of left it to us, so maybe something's going to happen with it. I know it's been his wish for something to happen, so we're going to try to make that happen. I just don't know when and how, and, you know, hopefully it will happen, you know.
Yeah, back there. Watch this one.
Wait, I'm sorry, Eric Singer said?
Yeah, Eric Singer said it would probably be a hawk if he was in the band.
Oh, right.
What would you be? Oh, she wanted to know what I'd be in makeup. I always say I'd be the dog. I don't know why, but it's a good question. And you know why Eric says the hawk? Eric Singer says the hawk, because he's got a hawk nose, which maybe one day he'll change, who knows?
What do we hear about from you?
You know, I have this, like, Jewish voice, I don't know. I'm really not a great lead singer at all. You know, I prefer to play through the guitar and express myself that way. And backgrounds are, you know, fun for me. We do that, but I don't know. I just, if I thought I could do it really well, I would, but... Yeah, the guy with the videotape machine who's gonna... You can buy these next week.
Paul's solo album.
Yes.
Is he in any bands?
Actually, my brother. Right now, he had a band for a while called Skull, which is kind of on hiatus in a sense. They didn't get it released in America, this project, and I played a little bit on it and wrote a song with him. The new thing he's doing is with this singer Graham Bonney, who's a really excellent singer. He's playing Rainbow, and they got a deal at least in Europe for sure, and in Japan at this point. They're recording, and in fact, there's two, maybe three songs that I co-wrote with that. So I'm pretty happy. They don't really have a band name right now. They were doing some gigs under one name, but they're going to change it. So look for that. I'm sure the fanzines are going to let people know. And hopefully it will come out in America, because I know, you know, it's hard to get stuff like that on import. You know, he's really talented, but, you know, it's really tough sometimes if you don't have hair down to your ass. You know, my brother's got a different kind of look if you people aren't aware of that. But he's a great player, and, you know, he played with Eric Singer, you know, with Paul Solo Tour, and, you know, he's, like, part of the Kiss family, and you know, we're real close, so I'm going to tell him you asked about him. Yeah, the guy with the hat.
It's evident that on the most recent Kiss album that you're playing is had a lot more input, and your true potential is being shown. How did you feel, say, in previous records being somewhat restrained, and how are you handling, say, now being not only the guitar player for Kiss, but Bruce Kulick, the guitar god or hero, whatever you want to call him?
No, you know, it's funny. I think in some ways I was a little too thoughtful in the studio, and we were trying to maybe be a little safe in some of the records in the 80s there, and, you know, maybe radio won't go for that, and I don't know. I think in lots of ways on Revenge we really, you know, really went for the full tilt on this, and that meant we had tougher songs, more riff oriented. We had Ezrin to be tough on us, or tell him to go, you know, take a hike if he wasn't doing the right thing either. And I think really those songs demanded a real kind of heavy duty intense guitar sound, and it's kind of odd how it all happened when Ezrin told me, look, I don't want these solos to be really nasty, you know. And I was like, what, you don't think I can do that? And he goes, no, I don't think you can do that. And that got me really pissed off, you know. I went to the closet and pulled out every like idea in the sense of junk pedals or whatever, just to get an aggressive sound. And we came over to my house, I have a little 12 track in my home, and they're like, this sounds good, Bruce, we like this. You know, in fact, the solo in Heart of Chrome that I was just doing, I had that written in my house to show the guys, and from there it just took off and everything was easy. You know, we knew the direction of the solos were going to be intense, heavy distortion, and almost out of control. And that's something I used to do, but I don't know why I didn't do it before, you know, but everything takes its time, right? Like fine wine, they say, right? Yeah.
I got a question. I'm puzzled on one of the Kiss albums. I wonder if Gene and Paul ever talked to you about it. The Elder?
The Elder, yeah. I mean, I wasn't there for that.
I know you wasn't.
Right. But I do know some about it. I mean, at some point, I mean, any band that's been around, you know, it's almost 19 years now and all, at some point they realized, well, let's try something different, and they got, like, ambitious. And I know it actually is a very good record.
Okay. Is there a movie for that?
A movie? No, well, that was another ambitious idea that, well, maybe The Elder could be, you know, we can do this and that. But obviously when it sold five copies at first or whatever.
Soundtrack to a movie.
No, I know, but that never happened. That was the goal, was to make it happen, you know. And, you know, it's a good record, but it was a little turn, you know, off the wrong direction for the band. And, you know, yeah, you know, but, you know, you try things and then you get back, you notice the next record was Creatures, which really has some great songs, you know, that really hang in there. Yeah.
What's your stage show going to be like tonight?
Oh, really great. Hopefully everybody here is going to be at the show tonight. We got a huge Statue of Liberty, okay, and I don't want to give away what happened,
but in
the middle of the show, things start to blow up and things happen to it. And I will tell you the opening song is Creatures of the Night. And it's a real exciting show. I'm real proud of the new set. And we'll do you prepare? We'll be there for 24 songs. So it's like 2 hours.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll tell you what.
I was gonna ask some kissing clothes too. Who has that?
No, I know a lot of people ask that question, whether or not, you know, losing Eric Carr really affected us on the record and all, and it really affected us all personally, of course, losing, you know, it's like, that's the closest guy I know that I was so close, like a brother who died from something as terrible as cancer. It was awful. But, it, you know, revenge, the kind of like direction of the album and all, was already kind of set and being driven already. That was just another, you know, like, oh my God, life can really, so, you know, another thing to deal with. And, you know, what was great was we were able to include that, you know, the song, which was from, practically from the Elder days, actually, the drum solo song that I wanted to riff on. All right, I'll take one more question and then I'll answer the other guy. Yeah.
How do you feel about the people that say that they criticize what's going on with another member after Eric died?
Well, you know, people don't like change sometimes, you know, and they accept, you know, it's hard for them to accept, well, they're used to this, you know. I know, I'm sure that Eric would want us to carry on, and I'm also sure that if people don't like the band without Eric Carr, then that's okay. You know, I have to accept that too. But I know Eric Singer's doing a great job, he's really professional and very talented, and I know all you people are going to see that tonight. But the idea was never to put a clone in the band and try to get, you know, we got to remember Eric Carr for who he was, and that's different from our new guy and all of that. You know, in the same way I'm not Ace and all that. Okay, so you know, all right, I got to get to. I just want to tell everybody, you know, at some point we're going to be recording the Live 3 finally. Okay. Yeah, I think maybe at Detroit or, you know, Auburn Hills. I'm not sure. And we got a new single coming out. We're putting out the ballad, even though that's not really the, you know, every time I is it look at you, look at me, okay. Video call MTV, you know, because sometimes they go, oh, this looks good, but it's Kiss, you know. You know, so the Kiss Army has to take over from there. We're all volunteers, right? So Kiss Alive 3 is going to come out. We're going to film one of these shows too, maybe the same one. So that's going to be a live video. You know about Extreme Close Up, right? It's pretty cool. I got to speak in it. Hey. And talk about my life and Kiss, you know, and there's a lot of cool stuff in there. Stuff that even surprised Paul and Gene, some of the baby pictures and stuff like that.
Exposed
too. And what was that?
Exposed too.
Yeah, kind of, but we changed the name because it's not too exposed.
No, that's it.
It's extreme close up.
It's pretty cool.
So what do we have happening? We got some stuff to do. What's this? This is the actual amp that I play on stage. No, just kidding. But I do practice through these. These are pretty cool. Alright, I'm gonna pick a special number, so you better be here, right?
We already died.
You better be here.
I already handed mine in.
Here we go. This is a good number. Everyone got that number ready?
Yeah.
It's tattooed on their arms, right? 52230. 30. This is a big lottery for the biggest money. Is that you? You got it? 52230. All right, we got a winner.
Shit.
It is.
Fuck.
And he's wearing a Motley Crue shirt. That's very cool. No, I'm friends with those guys, so I think it's cool.
That's very cool.
Which makes more than when I want you to talk.
He's got a kiss match on the back, so he's very cool.
Sweet.
Box. What else would you do?
A guitar.
Okay, so he's just going to get a table, and then you guys can kind of orderly fashion, we'll give you guys some autographs, and hopefully I'll stop sweating.
How do we order?
You gotta have the meanest piece. Yeah. I do a little solo tonight too, so cheers.
Yeah!
Money.
show tonight. Alright. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna have Bruce sign one of these 97 Rock t-shirts. Want everybody to come down to pre-concert bash. After you leave here, we're gonna be at the Super Bowl on Fifth Avenue by the arena.
We'll be there.
So come grab a cold one and hang with us.
Yeah. All right.
Also, definitely. We have the autographed guitar, which is somewhere around here. That's we're gonna be giving away tonight. So maybe before we leave, we can show that to you. And again, thanks everybody for coming out tonight. Let's tear it up and kiss, right?
We want to start the line from over this way, guys, so we can start to filter you back around the pool. Around the pool with you. You guys stay right here. Everybody will get an autograph.
Like it.
picture of me over there. Nathan, you gonna take a picture over there? Thank you.
Show's gonna be an excellent show tonight.
Yeah, Golden show up.
Do you have any
luck? Not the whole show.
Yeah, I'll get the picture. No, I'll get it. I knew that.
Just like
push shots. Take that.
He's got a hurl in too.
You want to mute that?
What, you want to get
it? Yeah, I'll get it.
No, I'm going to get one.
Oh.
Because he's got the video camera. And that's like.
Oh, wait, you going up now? Here, give me it.
Good
pick. All right, man.
Let's get
pleasure to meet you. You're the one who inspired me to play the guitar. Okay, I want you to sign my guitar.
Okay, cool. Okay.
Any particular spot? I don't care. On the front.
He does have a gold mark.
Some of these decals, maybe?
Yeah, I don't care. Whatever.
I'll show that way.
Yeah, that's my Dino playing guitar. And this is for you and the guys in the band.
Oh, cool.
I made this. Now, I don't know what you want to do with this. You know?
Probably send it to Eric's parents.
Yeah, you know, we made it. We got our names on the bottom and that.
All right.
We love you guys. Can I get a picture with you?
Sure. Hang on. Who's the photographer?
Oh, right there. That again.
This is my boy.
Did he get that work?
Get the flash. Take it again.
Sit it again.
Let me take care of this.
Hold the flash button in and push the button.
Yeah,
push
it.
You are tall.
All right.
All right,
man.
Kick our ass tonight.
All right, thanks. We'll see you later.
All right, I'll see you there.
Front?
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to die now.
Wait till that green light comes on. All right. Oops.
Make it a day.
Bruce Kulick. Say hi, Chip and Dave.
Hi, Chip and Dave. Or Chip and Dale.
Chip and Dave.
Say hi, Hit and Run.
Hi, Hit and Run. And I'm a wet mess.
And all the Uniontown.
Right. Okay, thanks.
Thanks, man.
All right.
Dave, give me a picture, son.
You can buy those tapes.
I can't breathe.